I hope everybody is safe and home. So yesterday we discussed about the dermal tissue. Now we'll discuss about what is the ground tissue. The third tissue is ground tissue. So what is ground tissue? So the tissue which adds weight or which forms the bulk of the plant body is called as ground tissue. So this ground tissue means it adds the weight. The weight of the plant will be increases with the help of the ground tissue. So depending upon the function, this ground tissue is divided into three types. So the first one is called it contains three types of cells: parenchyma, monenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. So first we will discuss about the parenchyma. So in the parenchyma, the cells contain thin cell wall. They contain the thin cell wall. So depending upon the function, parenchyma are again divided into four types. They are chloenchyma, chlorenchyma. So the parenchyma cells which performs photosynthesis, which contain chloroplasts. So such type of cells are called as chloenchyma. So you know that chloenchyma means chloroplasts, they help for the formation of food. So food adds weight to the plant. So chloenchyma. The second one is called as aerenchyma. The parenchyma cells which contain air spaces. These spaces are called as air spaces. So such type of cells are called as aerenchyma. These aerenchyma cells, they add buoyancy to the plants. So such type of cells you can observe in the aquatic plants. For example, you can say that lotus, Bellisneria. So in such type of plants you can observe this aerenchyma. So aerenchyma, they contain the air spaces which helps for the floating of the plants on the water. And the third one is called as storage tissue. So the third one is called as the storage tissue. So the parenchyma cells which stores the food are called as the storage tissue. For example, they take all the fruits, tubers, roots, stems, potato, beetroot, carrot. These all comes under storage tissue where the food gets stored. So the another one is called as water storage tissue. The parenchyma cells which store water. Such type of cells are called as water storage tissues or water storage cells. So they store the water. For example, the desert plants. The desert plants, what happens? The aloe vera or cactus. So they store the water in the stems. So they are called as the water storage tissue. So that's why parenchyma, though depending upon the function, it is divided into these four types: chloenchyma, aerenchyma, storage tissue, and water storage tissue. Now we'll discuss about what is chloenchyma. When you see the chloenchyma, when you observe, these cells are long. When you observe the cells under the microscope, you get that thickness. Here you can see the thickness. So these cells, you can say that they are the parenchymas. So this thickness here, the edges, you can observe under the microscope. Such type of cells are called as parenchyma. So what is the function of the parenchyma? So this parenchyma, it gives mechanical strength, mechanical support to the cells, especially juvenile plants or younger plants like pussy, spinach, amaranthus. Amaranthus and the Tortura. So the stems are very tender. The stems are very tender. So when the air blows, they may move, but they cannot break down. Why? Because of the presence of the parenchyma. So this parenchyma you can observe in the younger plants. Understand? Now we discuss about the another tissue that is called as the sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma. So sclerenchyma are the type of cells. So which contain the cell wall is very thick. The cell wall is very thick, and there they are the cells are dead. The cells are dead. So they offer protection. They offer protection, and these sclerenchyma cells also adds strength to the plant body, and as well as they tough. They are very thick sclerenchyma because of the thick cell wall. They are very tough. They contain the thick cell wall, so they are very tough, and they also give the mechanical strength to the plant. So main function of this parenchyma and sclerenchyma, they will not allow the plant to break down. So whenever the wind blows, so they will bend. You might have seen, but they will not break because of the presence of this type of sclerenchyma, parenchyma, cell wall is all will help for the protection of the plants. So this is about the ground tissue. So ground tissue, what is the main function of the ground tissue? It adds weight to the plant body. It makes the bulk of the plant body. So this ground tissue helps for preparation of food. It helps for the buoyancy in the aquatic plants. It stores the food, it stores the water, and it offers the mechanical support. So these are all the functions of the parenchyma tissue. Parenchyma cells, sorry, ground tissue. So in the next class we'll discuss about what is regarding vascular tissue. Okay, thank you.